Good morning, Philippines. Good afternoon. Good evening, America. This is your regular broadcast once again, the Restoration Mysteries of God, coming to you live from Manila, Philippines. And we are continuing our series from Lilith to the Watchers. And the story continues about this hybriding, but this is different kind of hybriding. Lilith introduced the hybriding, actually. It did not start in Genesis 6. It started way back in the time of Lilith, this mixture of these demonic angels. Physically, this is not spirit, just spiritual.
But Bar Francis, it's hybriding of the, it's already done by Rabbi Joshua. Okay, so hybriding from human into demon. Then about the Genesis chapter 6, according to the other denominations, the angels came down because they saw the daughters of men. They are the beauty of the woman, and they Mary or the Mary, the those one. So how is it true that these angels can have took woman and have what do you call that? They married that woman. So let's go to the outline.
Let's have an opening prayer first.
Already done by Brian Joshua.
Ah, I didn't hear it. Okay, so let's go to the outline. The first part of the outline will be the end time message version, as expounded by Brother Jackson Richard Gann. Of course, other end time believers, I don't know how they present it, but there's no contradiction between them. So, Brother Richard Gann has the most pictures, so we're going to use that. Please show the outline first. I hope the outline is spread from. Don't stay with this picture too long, because Facebook does sometimes show who is the longest picture. So, please go to the outline. So, Brother Simon, don't stay with this picture very long. First, let's show the outline. Barmenan, is it you who have the outline? So, zoom it. Zoom. Remove the unnecessary portion. It's good to read. It's better to read with white background. So it's also okay. So the outline, if you zoom this, we have letter A. This is the basic end time presentation. So later, what we're going to present is very different from that. But we're going to present the basic first. When you say basic, it comes from end time level one teaching, a teaching of Brother Jackson, Brother Gann, about Genesis 6. We titled it The Watchers. It comes from the book of Enoch. But the Bible also mentions the book of Daniel about the Watchers. So, Brother Ferdinand is... Okay, Brother Simon has finally gotten it. What happened? As presented by End Time Message, Raymond Jackson, Richard Gann. Letter B, then we're going to go to the book of Enoch. And we're going to mention a little about Daniel's Nebuchadnezzar, or watchers. Daniel will mention the word watchers. So they're true. The word watchers is true. Actually, there's a hidden revelation the word watchers. Letter C, where, as we talked about a while ago, is there a reality of hybridization of supernatural, the supernatural paranormal beings with humankind? Are those vampires, werewolves, shapeshifters, changelings, are they all true? Or are they just made up? Finally, letter D, the deeper meaning of the Watchers and the role of true believers. Of course. So let's go to letter A. What pictures do you have? So I hope we can show that landscape. Maybe show eternity to eternity. Then later show the what happened in Genesis 6, the lineage of Adam coming into the lineage of Cain. Adamic Cainite. It's not just there's a fornication. Is that your first picture? It's better to show the eternity first. Okay, that's eternity to eternity. So, too bad I cannot expand upwards. Could zoom on Adam and Eve. So, when was the time of Lilith? It should be before Adam and Eve. So, this is silent, a hidden mystery. Okay? That was what we tackled before. But we have evidences from the scriptures, not directly written, but indirect evidences that they, what the Jewish lore about Lilith is biblically sound. So after the fall, now look at the serpent. The serpent is like a repetition of history. Okay? The serpent will be possessed by Satan. So we have an idea, it happened before Garden of Eden. Then he would impregnate Eve. Then let's move on, Brother David, to the next chart of eternity to eternity here. So let's zoom on the two sons of Adam. Please zoom on the two sons of Adam. You can see here, Seth is the replacement son for Adam. That's how Genesis 4:25 says it. I've appointed me another seed instead of Abel, whom Cain slew. So this is the second son of Adam. Now here, you can see that there is an intermingling between Seth and Cain. And their intermarriages produced giants. So let's move here. Brother Gun shows a pyramid. Maybe pyramid was made by Enoch, according to their stories or what. Maybe from Larkins. So the giants. There were giants in those days. That's Genesis chapter 6. The giants came from where? The lineage of Cain. Where did the lineage of Cain came? From the previous serpent. Let me say, before it became a serpent. So now, maybe we can show some other illustrations of hybriding. That's the story of Genesis chapter 6. Later, you have to prepare the apostolic doctrine. Okay? So later, we're going to show that it could not be sons of God. But we're going to share it, the possibility, as a parallel, not direct from the verse. Okay, so that's the story in Genesis chapter 6. The sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and took upon them wives from which they chose. Polygamy started by Lamech, multiplied up, even after Lamech. Lamech was just the pioneer in polygamy. Okay, So let's go, let's show other illustrations of these intermarriages, intermingling of the seeds. Show your other illustrations where David, Menon, Simon. So that's one. That's another. Okay. So you have the descendants. There's another one that was shown a while ago in the booklet. I was hoping you could... Abel was killed by Cain. So Seth was the replacement son for Adam. And by the way, what happened in the Garden of Eden? Something happened in the Garden of Eden that changed a little bit of their genetic constitution. When Eve was deceived by the serpent and she was impregnated.
So you mean, Brother Francis, you mean in Eden, during the time when Adam and Eve, while there was tempting by the serpent, or after this, the temptation, and Cain was there. So is there any transformation from the genetic part, or you mean literal body of
a little bit for Adam, a little bit, not very big, not as big as Lilith was, a little bit for Adam. Maybe show Adam and Eve first. Okay, anyway, Adam and Eve had a little change in their genetic structure, that this did not come by reproduction yet. We were products of those reproduction. This came by external influence. And that's where we're going to talk later about the topic. Can people be influenced to change? Like werewolves, vampires, and many others. Can the spirit world influence our bodies to change? So there's a little change. What is your proof that Adam had a change? That death. The death gene was inserted in our genes. It was allowed by God. It was changed, modified by God for our protection so that we will not continue in sin. So the fact that we start to have sickness, disease, pain, and eventually death is an evidence that we have a genetic change. So before the flood, before the time of Noah, there was, in the time, in Genesis 6, it will just get worse. What happened in the garden, in the fall, after the fall, will get worse before the flood. And of course, even after the flood. So let's, do you have, so Brother Simon, show the illustration of the booklet of Gan about the different the mixture, how everyone else was infected. Brother Simon or Barmena, a while ago you showed that a while ago. It's in the booklet of Brother Gan. Could you open up to that? Okay, if you're not gonna open up, it's a wasted effort to get that. Okay, what other illustration do you have about hybriding? Is that the only picture? Okay. So if you're not gonna show the others, please, let's go to the apostolic doctrine, the basic teaching of the end time. Wait, you took too long for you to show that. Okay, that's the horse and the donkey would produce a mule. Okay, that's hybriding. That's a part of reality. Okay, of course, there was a Jehovah's Witness I met at school that shared to me Genesis chapter 1, according to its own kind. So he said it's impossible. But we know in reality, science, that there are hybriding in the world. Horse and donkey produces a mule. Tiger and lion produces a liger. and many more. So, what the Jehovah's Witness said, that I met at school, said that it's impossible for them to hybrid. It's because of Genesis 1, let every creature reproduce according to its own kind. That's the original plan of God. No intermingling. But that's the picture I was referring to a while ago. So I can show later how Cain would infect the whole of their generation. So the answer to the Jehovah's Witness reasoning, maybe other denominations will also give that reasoning, those who are against this belief of the serpent seed or this intermingling, is it is a transgression of God's law. Example, do not eat from the fruit. But they chose to eat the fruit. You can still transgress. Animals can still hybridize. It doesn't mean if it's written God's perfect will is to reproduce according to his own kind, man could not mess it up. And this is one example. And this is, could you go upward first? Upward first. This is a good illustration. Initially, there was no intermingling, you see? The first portion, Adam, his children are still pure. Cain, who has the hybrid blood, it is not yet broadcasted, but I have an audio in Kogyo End Time series that said the Cain, the thy seed and her seed. It talks about the blood of Cain. Okay, and the influence of the devil for that. Remember, we're gonna use what happened to Lilith and what happened to Adam and Eve in the garden. What happened to Lilith is no longer in the garden. She was cast out of the garden. But what happened to Adam and Eve also in the garden and outside the garden is a anointing that changes their physical constitution. So look at the side of Adam. It looks pure, right? It's all look white. But the genetic constitution of Adam has already changed. The genetic constitution of Cain also changed, but it's changed radically. The side of Adam, it changed minimally. And the proof is death. Because Adam inherited death already, okay? Adam and Eve, and their children inherited death. They inherited the possibility, the potential to disobey. That's what Genesis 6 about. It's another wave of disobedience. This time, much more. It multiplies. Okay, you can see how sin multiplies. Okay, so when the intermarriages happen, there's a lesson for us. Do not be unequally yoked with unbelievers. Okay, let's move down. Let's move down, Brother Simon. Let's show how it was infected. You see, gradually, the evil influence of the people of Cain to those of the mixed. You see that? The mixture until it reaches Noah. And Noah took 500 years old before he found a wife. That means he might be looking for a pure seed and he could not find any. Not just a pure seed that is worthy. Because we can find a virgin woman for a wife, but she might not be Berean also. It should be spiritual. So the reason Noah married a hybrid, Naama, it could be because she's the most worthy that he could find. All the rest are either corrupted or spiritually corrupt already, even though they're physically pure. Or the purity will no longer be existing. Remember in the time of Enoch, he quoted, not quoted, it was Jude who quoted him, "The Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints." He prophesied against them about their iniquities. So in the time of Enoch, seven from Adam, it was already very prevalent, this intermingling. It's like Christians mixing up with the world. It happened before, it's going to happen again. Lilith is an example that's a hidden mystery for many, for a singular person. And here in Genesis 6, there's an example of multiplying that sin, that transgression. Okay, let's move down further. What happened in the time of Noah? What happened to the generations, to majority? Almost everyone got infected. If everyone got infected, then no one is pure blood anymore. And their age started to decrease. Okay, now let's go to the apostolic doctrine that talks about the verses against the denominational teaching that angels cohabited with humans. Okay? So please show, maybe show the first page of apostolic doctrine just for others, to introduction to others of what that track is all about. Please help out if they're taking too long, others. So apostolic doctrine, let's move on to the apostolic doctrine track. So what we just showed a while ago is from the booklet of Brother Gann and others, from the chart, Eternity to Eternity. Right now, we're going to look up a track that we made. It's called the Apostolic Doctrine. And I expounded very lengthily on the original sin, the fall of man. Hello. Please show them now. Anyone, please help out if they're having computer difficulty. Apostolic doctrine.
With Brother, with Brother.
Again, what is your question?
My laptop is lagging.
Okay, that's the landscape, the folded track version. Brother Simon, close your share screen. Brother Simon, close your share screen. So, here, the Apostles' Doctrine. This is the first page. I just showed that. If you wish to ask for a copy, so there's the printable copy, which you fold it together. You can ask for a copy. Maybe you can print it in whatever country you are, because you can just download this format. Okay? So, if you have the e-tracks, I asked Brother Simon to download the e-track version. Did you do something about that? If not, maybe close your share screen. Maybe go to the next page. And we're gonna focus on that part. Brother Menan showed it here. Okay, close your share screen, Brother David and Brother Joshua. We just advertised the truck. And if anyone wish to ask for it, contact the name here, Joshua Cabalchera. Okay. Okay, so Brother, this is a good that maybe you can maximize it further. Close the other portions. So we start from letter E. This is under the fall of man. Can we still show the fall of man? If this is straight down, maybe you can show number 4, because we can see it's number 5. Let's see number 4 just for a background. This is number 4, the fall of man. This is inside the apostolic doctrine. Talks about the fall of Adam and Eve, the evidences in the Bible. Remember, just as the story of Lilith is not as of the Jews in their other books are not detailed in our Bibles, the same also with the original sin. It's not narrated in detail. We need evidences of different scriptures to paint a bigger picture. So this is the fall of man. What happened in the garden? The evidence about the trees, not literal, spiritual trees, and the body of the woman, typologically, that the name word, the word eat in the Bible, okay? Verses in the Bible that bodies are involved. That need to be edited. Literal chase virgin. You need to close the space there. Okay, now let's A, B, C, D. Now let's go to letter E. Letter E talks about the two seed lines. What we read a while ago. No, not what we saw a while ago in our illustrations about the two seed lines in Genesis 6. So what does it say? The seed of the woman, the seed of serpent. Okay. Letter E talked about two seed lines. So Cain was born along with Adam's firstborn. But Abel was killed by Cain. So Seth was a replacement. I didn't put it here, no? I should have put it here. Adam was appointed another seed instead of Abel. So Abel was the son of Adam. Now here, we're not going to go into detail about the proof about the original sin. So we're going to leave that for another broadcast, okay? But supposedly, we have lots of broadcasts about that. Let's go to the genealogy. In genealogy, in Genesis chapter 4 and chapter 5, the genealogy of Adam is separate. Genesis chapter 5 should have been written here, okay? So Genesis 5 is Adam's genealogy. Genesis 4 is Cain's genealogy. What happened in Genesis 6? They intermingled. So in their intermingling, I directly said it here, the genealogy of the sons of God. So I think this, we need some background. Could you zoom further, Brother Menon? So it could be read bigger. Zoom, just zoom the, no, just close the other, the left side, okay? So, I should have put here in the track that this takes for granted people know about Genesis chapter 6. It never mentioned, what was never mentioned? The sons of God. The sons of God. Ah, the line of Cain. Never mentioned as Adam's son, but always mentions irregardless. But the firstborn is always mentioned, good or bad. Okay, let's move on. The wicked and righteous seed lines mixed. That's in Genesis 6. I wonder if Genesis 6 is written here. Okay, let's move. Oh, see, here's Genesis 6. The sons of God cannot be angels. This is the focus of our broadcast here. This will be called the Watchers by Enoch in the book of Enoch. The sons of God can't be angels because number one, could you close your, no, Brother Simon, so they can read this much more clearly because we need to focus, emphasize on this. Please close your share screen, Brother Simon. So could you maximize further, Brother Menon? Close the left side. The enumerated pages in the left side, because we're just going to focus on this, just on this statement. The sons of God, so maybe extend that, maybe drag the margin, okay? The sons of God can't be angels because number one, the angels don't sin. Who are the sons of God? If not the direct children, Adam or Christ, those will be angels. But the righteous angels are, the sons of God are, is terminology for righteous angels, not fallen angels. But righteous angels could not sin. So they cannot be what Genesis 6 says, the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were fair. So the denominational interpretation is, they are heavenly angels seeing the beauty of the children of men, the daughters of men, and they took upon them wives, which they chose. So in the denominational interpretation, except for in the end time message, they interpret the sons of God as heavenly angels, supernatural beings. So here, we're stating in letter A that It cannot be because righteous angels do not sin biblically. Okay? Let's go to number two. So can't you drag the margin left? So to, ano? Number two, the wicked angels no longer called sons of God. So let's say the denominational apologists will say they are wicked angels. Did you know that the wicked angels are no longer called the sons of God? They're already called the devils, okay? Fallen angels. So number two, Genesis 6, the sons of God could not be fallen angels. They could not be, according to the scripture, because wicked angels are no longer called sons of God. Let's go to number three. Number three, their fall was before man. The angels did not fall after Adam. The angels fell before man, Ezekiel 28. Maybe a good picture would be the, you know, eternity to eternity. Or if you have pictures of the angels before. So, anyway, so the fall of the angels was not during Genesis 6. The fall of Lucifer was not during... are you saying that there were angels who tried to catch up in falling in Genesis 6? So that's the part that denominations could not explain, okay? Even for a young earth. If it is a young earth, when did the angels fall? Ezekiel 28 says Lucifer was on earth. He had the garden of stone. See? Okay, I think it's the same locality as where the literal Garden of Eden was. His garden of stone. That's why he was watching. Watcher, huh? Watchers. He was watching when God created man in his own image. Okay, let's go to number four. Oh, wait. Before we read number four, could you go to the left? What is mentioned? Isaiah 14. That's Nebuchadnezzar alluded to Lucifer, the fall of Lucifer. John 8:44 says, he was a murderer from the beginning. Wow, before Adam, there was a murderer from the beginning. Who was the murderer, first murderer? Satan, your father, the devil. So there was murder before the time of Adam. Good for another topic, which is, are there prehistoric hominids before Adam? Okay, question.
I have a question.
Okay.
From the verse that you just talked a while ago about the Satan being murdered. So if we're talking about the beginning, so when in the beginning there's already a murder. So who did Satan murder? That's my question.
I believe there are also humans. Let's give an example to our time. We have people today living like animals. When I say animals, they don't look mushy and dirty, okay? They might look decent, well kept, with an expensive suit. But they're considered animals because they don't know God. They're not going after God. They want to live their lives out, playing, having enjoyment in this world. They try to enjoy this world while they're still alive because they don't recognize that God. They don't believe in the afterlife or God has an instruction about outward life. So they're like deists, atheists, agnostics. They are lukewarm people who don't want to know about anything about God. They're like animals. But can you still murder, kill them like animals? No, you cannot. When we slay a chicken, a goat, a pig, or a cow, you cannot equate that with slaying other people who don't know God. You're still going to be held accountable for that. So there are human form before Adam. There are creatures of God that are in the human form. So, and this is one... Okay.
So you're saying, Brother Rip, when a
Brother
creature,
Simon, while Enoch is asking, could you show the eternity to eternity, the prehistoric time?
So
Please show it my
so what you're saying, Brother F, when a person or a being that knows or has a knowledge or it has a capability to know the his creator, so when you kill that being, that's murder. That's what you're saying, right?
Even if the human form does not know God, they're like animals, it's still murder when those people will be killed. Okay, Brother Joshua, could you search the goddess of fertility? Okay, see that? That is before Adam. Could you zoom that, Brother Simon? Zoom the portion, the circle. So zoom that further. Temporarily close your share screen, Barmenan. So the zoom could be bigger. And Brother Joshua, search, or Enoch, search for the goddess of fertility, the figurine, okay? Okay, look at that. Temporarily close your share screen, except if the computer is slow. You need to maintain that, okay? See that? There are prehistoric humans, prehistoric animals. Those are reality because the fall of the angels was not in the time of after Adam. It was before Adam, okay? So, I'd like to add this. If you can show the goddess of fertility, can anyone search for that? Brother Joshua, that's Lilith. No, that is after Adam. That is during Sumeria. I'm looking for the goddess of fertility that is a carving. It looks like a woman with a big belly. There it is. There it is. If you look at your illustrations, look at the lower left side. That's the one. That's the goddess of fertility. The singular carving there. Okay, the singular, not the that the sophisticated one. The one on the left side, third picture from the left. Focus on that. Blow it up. So please close your share screen, Brother Simon, for the moment. Could you zoom that? That's the goddess of fertility. Now remember, this was not made during the time of the Sumerians or after Noah. This was not made during the time of Eve, the mother of all living. And before, I was thinking it was Eve. They were depicting Eve. No, that was not Eve. That was Lilith. You know when this was carved? This was carved before Adam. This was carved tens of thousands of years ago. I should have included this in our previous broadcast. So this is, the goddess of fertility is not completely the type of Eve. Eve is a small type. The perfect type is Lilith. Okay? So, what happened in Genesis 6 is just a repetition of what happened to Lilith. What happened to Lilith is also what happened to what became the serpent. And that's why the serpent tempted Eve, as Lilith became the tempter of human men. Who are the men that Lilith fornicated with? These are prehistoric humans or pre-Adamic. Let me use the term pre-Adamic. The prehistoric word is also all right, but pre-Adamic is much more accurate. So before Adam, are there human form beings? There are. And biblically, is it against the Bible? No. Let us make man in our image. So there was a man that was not in the image of God. These are animals. That was the before the it became one of them became the serpent. Before it became a serpent, it was in a human form. Okay, so this prayer, that's why this carving is evidence. It is not Eve is not the actual type of the goddess of fertility. The actual type of the goddess of fertility is Lilith, Semiramis, and Jezebel, their later manifestations. And so women of today, the liberation movement. Okay, one thing about Lilith in our previous broadcast is the revelation about the supernatural beings. can a human being be influenced by supernatural angels? But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's finish this letter A. Letter A, we're presenting the Bible according to the basic end time message. Brother Branham, Brother Jackson, Brother Gann. Brother Gann and Brother Jackson goes into detail. That's why I mentioned the name and give credit to them, because they can go into details. And I even went to other details here in this track that they did not mention. Let's go to number four. So we're still refuting that the sons of God, so the daughters of men, they're not angels. They're not angels from heaven. Okay? So number four, angels cannot marry. What did Christ say in Matthew chapter 22, verse 30? Can anyone read or quote to me? In the resurrection, they no longer marry or are given. Who are in the resurrection? The people. The ones the Pharisees were asking Christ.
Yeah.
Okay.
But enough. I have a quick question. Because the subject was about the religious group, if I'm not mistaken, that they are asking Christ about the marriage. Well, they have given Christ an example of a
woman who had
a woman, and I think it's husband. Seven husband that
he was widowed seven times. Yes, widowed seven times.
So the context was in the resurrection, right?
Yes.
So, but this is only my hypothesis, Brother Repa. So the subject was in the resurrection, but what if the subject was currently right now? Is it possible for an angel to have marriage when the resurrection are still far? Because the subject was in the resurrection, right? If I'm not mistaken. So the angels do not marry.
But angels can influence our genetic structure. That's what I was sharing a while ago in Adam, in the Adamic time. That's why death was imputed to Adam.
So this is my question.
The supernatural anointing of changing of the genes.
So that's in the end time, we're teaching that there was a crossbreeding between the serpent and the woman. So, but the problem is that the serpent was under the influence of Lucifer, or what we know as Satan.
Satan, no longer so, Lucifer.
So when that he was under the influence of Satan, so who has the control of the body of serpent? Is it the serpent or is it the spirit being?
Let me teach you first a better terminology. I use the term before he became the serpent. That's a better term. Because if you use the word serpent, the end time believers memorize that the word serpent is not a snake. The word serpent is like a man, a form of a man, like that.
Yes.
So we need revelation, okay? When we read the scriptures, we need insight behind. When you read the word serpent in the Bible, in Genesis chapter 3, it is a flashback term. It's in the present, and at what time when the Moses was writing it, it's already a serpent. But in that, when you go flashback, that word was flashback in the past, but it was not called a serpent. It was only called serpent in the present. But in the past, it was not called a serpent. Like Lilith, it was not the original night creature. It's not the original name. So the serpent is not the original name. Okay? So the better term we can use is before he became the serpent. The serpent before. So you need that term. So to clarify it. So we won't make the same mistakes as others who don't know language. Okay? So, your question is, did the serpent have, or the serpent that became the serpent before it was a serpent, Did he have control over himself? I would say semi and no. Sometimes the devil will manifest, sometimes it will not. In courtship, so this is something not written, of Eve to sin, it's not very obvious. You know why? When the devil manifests, it's not all the time. Sometimes he appears good. We have false brethren today that appear good, that might help you out, but later, in the end, they're Nicolaitan. They want your destruction, or they want to remove your ministry from you. They want to close people's minds. But there will be a time that they are good, honest. Sometimes they are shapeshifters. This is a perfect type of Genesis 6. When creatures of the night can change form, these false ministers transform themselves into an angel of light. So that before he became a serpent, when he still looks in a human form, the devil does not manifest all the time. It took 100 years or less to gradually influence so the serpent does sometimes have control over himself and sometimes not. Or that became the serpent, he had control, or sometimes he had no control. I can use an example what Brother Branham explained about Jesus Christ. Sometimes it was God speaking through Jesus Christ. Sometimes it was Jesus Christ speaking of himself as a son of God, as a man. Sometimes Jesus Christ can speak the voice of God, the words of God, in the first person. That's how Brother Branham explained it. Sometimes he speaks as God the Father. Sometimes he speaks as the Son of God. The same thing that happened to the serpent. The same thing that happened to the ministers. Ministers do not always appear Nicolaitan. Do not always manifest. I have a detractor who successfully undermined my ministry. And most of the time, you can see him very meek, very charming. But a few times, I saw his face change. Like later, we're going to have some videos of those people changing faces. But those are supernatural beings already. I'm talking about human persons that would manifest Nicolaitanism. So the serpent does not always manifest the devil. So Adam would not be suspicious. Of course, Adam would not be always by Eve's side. So when Adam will leave Eve's side, then a little bit courtship, a little bit like that. A little bit flattery, okay? That's happening in the world today. Okay, we're taking too much time. Let's finish this. The sons of God cannot be angels because angels do not marry. In the narrative of the denominations, when sons of God directly married with the children of men. Matthew 22 says, in the resurrection, they will be like angels. They neither marry nor are given in marriage. Given in marriage, meaning women. So, sisters that are resurrected are also like angels. They're no longer given in marriage. Unlike the teaching of Mormons or the group of children of God by Moses Berg, they believe that. But angelic sex, but that's demonic, okay? That's what happened to Lilith, and that's what gonna happen in Genesis 6. Now, before we go to my proposed alternative, not alternative, an additional parallel application that's very similar to the denominational version, let's fix this first in the biblical. Biblically, that direct application of verse does not apply that angels cohabited with humans. The closest you can do is possess. Like how the devil possessed the serpent that later became the serpent, the fallen angels can possess, can influence the daughters of men, the people of the earth, to intermarry, to forego the division of God, the separateness of God, sanctification of God. So the devil can, when they possess people, the people can have supernatural powers also. So when they intermarry, this is still within the bounds of the scriptures that is being taught by this Brother Gunn and Brother Jackson, Brother Branham's sons of God. Okay? We don't go contradict scripture when we say the angels need an angelophany. I'm talking about fallen angels. They need an angelophany in order to do their thing, to fornicate. Even today, even the serpent. Did you know who is this Yung Myung Moon? He teach that and many others. It was Satan who fornicated with Eve. But that was in the mind. They think the serpent is just a spirit being. But we believe there is a physical being that was used by the devil, possessed by the devil, in order to impregnate the woman. That's what happened. That literally really happened. It happened again in Genesis chapter 6. And this is within the bounds of scriptural direct application. Okay? The fallen angels will possess other human beings to make them intermarry. Okay? To produce kids that are unbelievers. Like many children of our church who are not yet taught to what is the priority in life. They're still living in traditional ministry of attending church is just a boxed in ritual. So that's as far as we go. Now we're gonna go to letter B. Could you show the outline? What is letter B all about? Maybe we can get ahead of ourselves because our time might run out. In letter C, I'm going to talk about, is it possible, letter C, is it possible, aside from the sons of God as the sons of Adam, when they fell, could it also represent a parallel application wherein the fallen angels, like the fallen sons of Adam, the fallen sons of Adam parallel to the fallen angels, could it be possible that the fallen angels produce hybrids among men? The closest we can say scripturally, even as it happened to Lilith, because I believe there are hominids that Lilith fornicated with, but she was granted supernatural power for in the spirit becoming one with the devil, like a witchcraft, okay? Like in witchcraft. So the other possibility we're talking about, aside, I believe this is one avenue. This is a scriptural avenue where demonic influence of supernatural power can enter in. But is it possible? Can a spirit directly influence? I answered that already a while ago. Adam was influenced to die. His genes was influenced by God supernaturally, not by reproduction, to die. So the line of Adam dies, the line of Cain dies, but the line of Cain is much worse than the line of Adam. Now, I thought this was the question of Bar Enoch, but I'm going to answer it anyway. Is it possible without the resurrection, can we change our bodies for the better? The answer is yes. Bar Menon, do you remember in Carolina that I was discussing this external influence aside from hybriding or reproduction that our bodies can be changed but for a long time, for a longer period of time? Do you remember that, Bar? And Pastor Alto was questioning that. Do you remember that, Bar Menon? He's not here. He's not here. Okay. So no one would remember that. Only he could remember that. No one here listening was there in Carolina. So I shared that before. Can we change our physical constitution without the resurrection? And I would say it will happen. When? It will happen in the millennium. In the millennium, the serpentine gene will gradually be dehybridized. I learned from Pastor Jonathan Togonan the term dehybriding. Dehybriding means removing the stains. So, Vermenant, if you can change the illustration to the millennium, that is going to happen. When you reach the eternal age, no more traces of this serpentine gene. I remember in Carolina, I used the serpentine gene. Did Adam receive a serpent seed? I would say yes in the spirit, but not in the body. But in the spirit, it can still influence your genetic structure. I use the word serpent seed. Okay? I use the word serpent seed. So even without these hybriding intermarriages, you can still receive serpent seed. When Adam fell, did he not disobey? His disobedience is the serpent seed. And is there a genetic nature for that? There is. Okay, that's the millennium. That's the eternal age. Before you reach the eternal age for 1,000 years, there will be a gradual change in the constitution of the sheep group, the sheep nations that will be allowed to repopulate the millennium. So there will be a change. If there is a change in favor for God, these are different from the resurrection change, okay? Resurrection change is instant in the twinkling of an eye. This change of the body's constitution will take 1,000 years for natural people left here on earth to survive, to repopulate in the millennium. So if it's possible to do that for God, like Matthew 22:30, if we're going to be transformed to angels, can Lilith and many other beings, humans, transform into demons? Can they transform into demons? When I say demons, supernatural beings, they're no longer humans. Is it possible? Let's let her see. So, we might run out of time. So, let's summarize letter B and letter C. Maybe let's move to letter B, the book of Enoch. Okay. Brother Simon, Brother Joshua, please show pictures about the book of Enoch. We're going to go through it very fast because our time is very short. Okay. We have, we're nearing just 30 minutes to go. Please change your picture to the book of Enoch. So let's talk about the watchers. Here comes the word watchers. Daniel. Daniel mentioned the word watchers. So before we go to the book of Enoch, let's go to the book of Daniel. There are two scriptures that mention the word watchers. What is he referring to? It's the same thing that the book of Enoch was referring to. Who are the watchers? They are angelic beings. They're watching. Let's give some scripture. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 12. Verse 11 talks about the suffering of Christ, the glory that should follow. Verse 12 talks about the angels are waiting for it to happen. They're aspiring to look onto what God is about to happen. I hope you have collected verses I asked for. To whom it was revealed not unto themselves, but unto us they did minister the things which are now reported unto you by them. These are the watchers, huh? Which have preached the gospel and the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven. These things the angels desire to look into. You look at the word look into there because they're watchers. There are two kinds of watchers, the fallen angels and the righteous angels. The watchers are God's ministers or God's enemies. Okay? God's spoilers. And we can also be watchers, but that will be letter D in our. So I hope you collected the verses about the angels. What other verses do we have? Do you have the verse where Christ said that the angels look at the face of our God? Where they're talking about in judging men, they always look at the face of the Father in heaven because of these little ones, the human people. So I asked you to look for that earlier. It's in somewhere in the Gospels. The Acts chapter 6 is a person that shone like the face of an angel. But they look upon the face of the Father. You just search face of the Father. Face of the Father. So, my Father's face. Google it. So, they will. You can easily find it. So, I asked that earlier to look for that verse. Another verse I asked you to look for is in, maybe in Ephesians, we are made spectacles unto God and to angels and to men. So another, maybe look for it. Brother Simon, maybe search for it if your computer's hanged. Spectacles. So Barmenan is looking for the face. You need to use Google because Google can immediately. Oh, here it is. Oh, no, not this. So you just need you someone needs to Google it. There are many of you. Please see the face of their Father in heaven. The angels see the face of the Father in heaven. You need to Google it because the exact wording cannot look for it. We're gonna take up time. Oh, here it is. Take heed that ye despise not one of these little ones. For I say unto you, Brother Simon, close your share screen. So it will not take up space. That for they do always behold the face of my Father which is in heaven. Because the angels are watchers, okay? Fallen angels, righteous angels that did not fall, they are guardians of the little ones. Why are they looking at the face of our Father in heaven? Because they're waiting for instructions, what to do, whether to chastise the children, his children or not. Okay, the angels are already graduate with that chastisement. So what other verse we need? Ephesians chapter 4, I think. We are made spectacles. You search the word spectacles of we are made spectacles of Corinthians 4:9. It was not in Ephesians. God had set forth us unto the apostles last as it were appointed unto death, for we are made a spectacle unto the world and to angels and to men. So angels are watchers. Later in our letter D, we should be watchers ourselves like the angels because we're supposed to be angels of God, messengers of God.
Nobody.
Okay, show the other pictures of the book of Enoch while Brother Josh was asking. Hurry up because our time is running out.
My question is, if angel can marry, then who's the called son of God? And please enlighten me, I didn't understand the part of it.
If you were listening a while ago, I said they do not marry. If you looked at the track, they do not marry. So that is the refutation that angels directly cohabited with men. But if they possess someone else, they can give supernatural power to that someone else and they can multiply and their offspring can be demons. They do not directly marry, but they can influence the spirit. So this is a supernatural fornication.
So
transferring power to you.
Meaning okay. To say, like.
Brother Simon, rotate the pictures of Book of Enoch. So, because your time is almost to run out. Okay, Brother Menon. Huh? It could not be shown here? Ah, so you rotated it there already. Oh, I have to look it up. Okay. So just let me know if you're showing it there. Okay. So it cannot be played here. Too bad. Okay. Yes. In the spirit. In the So he has she has already been possessed before. When Lilith was being possessed, it at the beginning she could not change immediately. First timers do not change. But as time goes on, it changes. So, and how much more if there are fornications with other beings of the night? So she did not just fornicate with pre-Adamic hominids. She also, there are other pre-Adamic hominids that are become changelings already. And she also fornicated with them. And this thing happened again in Genesis 6, parallel to what's happening to the sons of God and the daughters of men of Adam and the Cainite line. Within their descendants, there are those that happens. Okay, so if you can show Genesis chapter 6, these were mighty men of renown. You can show the superheroes. I hope you can share it here in Telegram. Okay, that when you idolize the superheroes in the comic books and movies, look. They're like that. That is a description of Genesis 6. The Genesis 6 does not only describe giants. Could you rotate the book of Enoch? Because we're running out of time. Bar Simon. So while I'm explaining, I hope you could bring up that folder.
Francis' question first. Whether
rotate it.
Francis...
rotate it while someone is asking questions. Okay.
So you mean angel can put their characteristic or their what do you call that their pace, their action, their image in the person, in the human. Denomination
yes,
says
Christians in the resurrection.
Denomination says it was just a spirit. So sometimes they don't explain that because if they encounter demons in the person, they just explain it as because of the spirit. The spirit control the human. But how could we explain that the person become like demon,
Please close your share screen, and Brother Simon, please rotate the pictures because we're running out of time. I've been asking you for that several times already. Rotate your pictures, okay? So I'm gonna answer the question. Even as God can create things from the natural, can modify change the natural things. The devil can change supernatural things. And even as God can heal the sick, can make miracles, okay? You believe God can make miracles, right? Not just healing the sick, but many other things like parting the Red Sea. The supernatural realm can influence the natural realm. So do as God can resurrect a person into glorified bodies. Remember, what is a glorified body? A glorified body, Brother Simon, please rotate your picture. A glorified body is a body that is infused with God. God's power, God's glory. It is immortal. As it was described in 1 Timothy 6. It was God who is immortal, then it was the Son Jesus Christ, then the bride that will be resurrected like Melchizedek, thou art a priest forever after the power of an endless life. So if God can influence that, God, the devil can influence those fallen to change their bodily constitution, to have supernatural powers. They have supernatural powers. Can you still show it here in Telegram, the rotate the pictures of the book of Enoch? We have not discussed the book of Enoch yet, but we're going to show illustrations of the change. Finally, you're rotating it. I need to go to the series in order to see the transformation. Did you finish showing that in the series? The transformation. We have examples of transformation. We're going to show letter C first before we show letter B. Letter B is the book of Enoch, the Watchers. Letter C is our examples of these shapeshifters. Okay, these influence change. Can you show it here in Telegram? Because if I'm going to go to the series, so it might take time. And I don't know if it's still there. Okay. So, I don't know. I'm looking for the... I need some... I think... It's not here. It's not here. It was not shown. It was not shown. Or it was has not yet been shown. Okay, I think you have to show it in Telegram. The few minutes we have left. Okay. So right now, we're showing what? The book of Enoch. The sons of God so came into the daughters of men. Do we still have time to discuss the abduction of Enoch by the Watchers? We're not going to discuss that anymore. A shortage of time. How about the giants? Can you show the giants? The offspring of the sons of God and daughters of men. Now, they're giants that are super large. I think they're supernatural beings already. Oh, the giants you have is this, okay? There's an AI-generated picture. The giants are very, you know. So you don't have that picture? The giants in the book of Enoch? Only the illustration of Brother Gan. Okay. So we don't have other... Okay, so okay, do we have other illustrations about the book of Enoch? So I'm just gonna narrate what the book of Enoch contains. First, it contains the abduction of Enoch. And
can you say the specific phrase on the book of Enoch? Because if you search it on Google, there's nothing there. No, so if you want some pictures, then you can just tell.
I thought you already prepared it. Okay.
No,
I requested for you to study the book of Enoch.
For the book of Enoch.
After you study, you could get pictures of it.
It's okay. Only the book, but you can say the more specific phrase or the phrase that you can search it on Google.
Okay, I'm just going to remind that I requested for you to study. Then, after you study it, the summary of it, then look for the pictures, okay? So, if you're gonna search it in Google, then I'm just gonna enumerate what is mentioned in the book of Enoch. First, there is the abduction of Enoch. So, there's the alien conspiracy theorists, ancient astronaut, ancient aliens, like that stuff, where they get it from, okay? Then, after the abduction of Enoch, to their supposed spaceship, there are the watchers that gave him prophecies about what's gonna happen on Earth. Then there are the watchers that came down to Earth. So these are supposed to be fallen angels. And they cohabited with women to produce giants. So that's the second part. Then there came the flood. That's the final act. So here, while the giants were in the Earth, there were still mighty men of renown. These are the days of the superheroes. Oh, don't waste your superheroes, Bar Simon. Show it here now. Rotate it here now. Mighty men of renown. So, so you didn't prepare for the, didn't study the book of Enoch and prepare for the pictures. But these are one of the mighty men of renown. I'm not saying Spider-Man was literally there. When artists today make commercializations about superheroes, that is what happened in Genesis chapter 6. Nimrod was one of them, but Nimrod was not before the flood. Nimrod was after the flood. But before the flood, there were people who had supernatural powers, not just giants. There were many demonic creatures that have supernatural powers. Now, Wonder Woman espouses more the spirit of Lilith. Okay? A woman can be strong, can be stand against the man. Okay? But those were the mighty men of renown. It happened in Genesis chapter 6. Who else? Are they just the two superheroes you look you downloaded? You should show a lot of them, okay? When I was broadcasting my studio, I showed a lot of them. Don't be transfixed on her. Move on to others. Okay, so what happened during Genesis chapter 6? The earth was polluted, as it was said, and God saw the wickedness of men was great upon the earth. Is it happening today? Are there supernatural beings living with us today that we don't know? Okay. So there are. Okay, thank you for those illustration, Brother Joshua. So what happened there now is what happened before. The intermingling of Christians today are the intermingling of the sons of Adam before. And they produce supernatural beings. These are also the product of a different kind of watchers, the fallen watchers, the watchers of the devil. Okay, there are others. Simon tried to catch up, but maybe close your share screen, Brother Joshua, so Simon can blow up his pictures. Blow it up. Don't waste the black space left and right. Okay, thank you. Okay, just move up and down. So you see that literally there are people today who have supernatural powers, starting from witches, sorcerers, shapeshifters, vampires, werewolves, and many other things. And when did that start? From the time of Lilith, it already started. In the time of Genesis 6, it just got worse. They were anointed by these watchers. There are two kinds of watchers. The watchers from God and watchers from the devil. The watchers of God decreed and told Enoch that there is going to kill all humanity, whole humanity with a flood. So all humanity will be killed with a flood. Maybe you can show, we have 20 minutes to go. Maybe you can show the, maybe you can show the transformation, modern videos of transformation. That we don't take too long on this. Could you show Simon Menan the transformation to a werewolf, transformation to a vampire? There are videos today. The Angolan boy, a black boy, his teeth grew fangs. Of course, in his transformation to grow fangs, of course, it took him some time. That's the video we have. So, could you show that video? Could you show the video also of the little girl possessed by the devil and they had the face change? If you don't want to show the video, at least show the picture. Let's say you don't play the video, just show the picture.
Okay, hello.
Brother Joshua, are you having trouble with the computer, Brother Simon? Hello. Berminan, could you show the video? Maybe you already have a copy of that. Okay. Our time is very short and you're not going to show the video. Let's go to letter D. Need to practice, okay? So, let's go to letter D while you're trying to show the video. Because that's letter C. Okay? So, We need to be very fast because we started late, okay? So this is a video of a werewolf, a transformation to werewolf. Close your share screen, Brother Simon. So this is not the first one I saw. There's a black man that also transformed. So whether it's a fake or true, there are real persons who are like that. So this is, the other side is the vampire. He will grow fangs. He has become a celebrity now because he's taking advantage of YouTube clickbaits, number of likes, okay? So they exist today. Let's say denominational churches don't believe this exists. Not all of them, but some do believe. I wonder about the end time message if they believe this. Brother Simon, could you close your superheroes? Please show Rebecca Brown. He came to set up this free. Show many pictures about Rebecca Brown and his book, and her book. I'd like to introduce her. And there's another person, Emmanuel Eni Amos. So maybe you can search for that. So you see that boy transforming. So you cannot show the woman being possessed anymore, the young girl. So let's show, Brother Simon, could you show a, oh, that's the black man I'm talking about when he transformed. Because they're making money out of it. But before YouTube, before I heard about that before, I know real persons who really testified those things are real. They really transformed. Barmenan, maybe his parents also saw that, okay? So,
okay,
Brother Simon, please close. Please show Rebecca Brown. And another, please search for Emmanuel Eni Amos. He also has testimony. The testimony of Emmanuel Eni Amos, he was transported. He also had a supernatural power before he became a Christian. Emmanuel Eni Amos was transported by the Spirit like David, like Philip in the rapture, no? Translation. He was translated to another place under the sea where they had laboratories about women makeups and many things that could cause vanity. So I hope you can show that. If you cannot show that, let's go to letter D because our time is almost out. So just search for it, what I mentioned, Rebecca Brown, he came to set the captives free. Search for Emmanuel Eni Amos, their testimonies about the reality of the spirit realm and supernatural beings. But our topic is about the Watchers. So what about it? Could you show the outline? Do you have pictures of the Watchers that applies to believers? A good song is Wayne Watson, Such a Time as This. It's a good song, no? Okay, finally. That's the book of Rebecca Brown, but there are many books that talks about, I wonder if that's the book. I think that's the book that talks about the bride of Satan having supernatural powers fighting each other. But they could not harm Christians. Now, if there are heavenly watchers or demonic watchers, are there human watchers? Yes, we have. We have non-Christian apologists that are against the Christian belief. They're watchers of evidences that could find fault in our beliefs. Okay? And look for other books of Rebecca Brown. And look, please search for Emmanuel Eni Amos. Pastor Roland frequently talked about him before when I was first time in Cogeo. Emmanuel Eni, several people have shared to me about Emmanuel Eni Amos. It's a supernatural experience book, okay? Here in the PBMA, they have supernatural experiences. And there are watchers that are looking for errors in the Bible, errors in our belief. There are detractors of our belief. They're also called the watchers. I'm talking of human watchers. Could you open the Bible? That's Emmanuel Eni Amos, okay? I think. So, he had a testimony about the supernatural. But we don't have much time. We're talking about end time watchers. Are they also watchers? Yes, they're also watchers. Because they testified for us what they experienced, okay? But what about end time watchers? We have eternity to eternity. As true believers, as end-time message believers, we are also watchers of prophecy. We're watchers of families. We're watchers of events. We're watchers of... We're guarding each other, exhorting one another, admonishing one another. We're brothers keepers. That's also watchers. Because who are the angels of God? They are ministers of the heirs of salvation. That's Hebrews 1:14. And true believers are ministers also. They're also angels of God. And we're watchers. We're not just watching over prophecy. No, we're watching also of progressive revelation. Could you open the Bible? Could you search the Bible verse? Brother Menan, I'm going to end it here. Watch and pray. Please look for the word watch and pray, Brother Menan. Close the share screen or look for the Bible. Who is this? What discussion are they talking about? We don't have time. What is this all about? Could you tell me about it?
So, people watchers, it is about exhorting one another.
That's your illustration for the watchers. A good picture you can look for are Berean Christians. In the Berean folder, there are Christians who are studiously studying the word and looking at prophecies. So, you can show prophecies, okay? And look at the family. The family, okay? So the watchers who is on the side of God in our church, they are those who are looking after each other. They're not selfish. I don't care about you. You despised me before. No, you have compassion for them. Being a watcher, you watch also for others' care. Okay, that's written in the Bible. And you watch also prophecy. Ezekiel 38:39, maybe you can show that, no? Prophecy. Oh, that's like the Bereans, studying the scriptures day and night. So watchers also are sensitive of new topics. Whenever someone brings a new topic, they search the scriptures day and night. Those are also watchers. So looking up onto the cross, you're looking up through the progressive word of God. If you progress in the word of God, you're also watchers. There are new topics. There are new revelations. You are also watchers. You're looking at world events. You're watchers. You are no different from an angel. The difference is you have not received your glorified body yet. Okay, are there questions? Rotate the pictures for what I mentioned. Prophecy, eternity to eternity. Like the word watcher is expanded to that. Because the watcher angel foreshadows the watcher believer, the bride of Christ. Okay, so could you show the word bride, just the word bride illustration? It's called the word bride because the bride is studious over the word, sensitive over prophecy. The word bride, the illustration. Okay, any questions? The few minutes we have left. Okay, that's prophecy, you see? Who can see this? Let's say you're looking at this chart. If you're not interested, then you're not a watcher. But true believers want to know about this. So even if just by chart you can see, your mind can be transported to the future. You're a watcher of future events. You're a watcher of what's going to happen in the church, what should be done in the family. You have a discernment of the dangers of lukewarmness or idleness. Okay, question, Brother Simon.
Okay, my question is all about, again, on the daughters of men. Is there a possibility there an intermingling of the people with the angels of God, like the fallen angels?
I already said that a while ago. The possibility is through another person. If it's direct, it is in the spirit realm, like possession.
Yeah. But on the verse saying that they are looking for the women and also the daughters of men, So even though so meaning to say that you're saying that that spirit will go to a people or a man that can intermingle on the
I call that parallel. That means to say, when you read Genesis 6, the direct application of reverse are not those Lilith-type supernatural beings. But there's evidence in Genesis 6 that there are supernatural beings there. But it is parallel. When the sons of God saw the daughters of men, what is not written there, there is the anointing of the devils, the fallen angels, to men.
Okay. But
many wives.
On your last Sunday, you're saying that there is a goddess of intercourse and also there is a spirit of intercourse. So, like
incubus and succubus, yes.
Incubus and succubus. So, meaning to say that there is a possibility, like Lilith is a spirit, right? He became a spirit or a demon.
So when we sleep, we have these wet dreams on nocturnal emissions. These are their manifestations.
Oh, their manifestation is coming on your mind, like dream vision.
Yes. Now, what happened in the Genesis 6? What happened in Genesis 6, it's not no longer a dream. They're manifesting it. They're fornicating all around. They're displaying their bodies like it was a commodity, okay? Well, that's Lilith's spirit. But here in Genesis 6, that spirit multiplied. And we should be watchers. We should be warners. That's people, they're not yet stripping, okay? But even, let's, in our church, when you are trying to be, to celebrate, to be happy, okay? Well, that's the demonic spirit of sex, okay? When you're trying to be happy, you're inviting the devil. This is something very high I want to say. People who are celebrating today, they're inviting the spirit to reveal. Let's say they look so innocent, they look so wholesome. But it's a deception. Because in the future, they're just sacrificial virgins in the temple of Nimrod. Okay? The innocent people we see today, let's say you watch the variety shows, singing worldly music, dancing to the beat, but they have wholesome families, supposedly. They even claim to be Christians, eh? But they're sacrificial virgins for this. So, in Genesis 6, it happened, okay? Some were chosen as supernatural beings, to be supernatural beings. Some are not. But we see that manifestation all over the globe today, okay? The whole world is being infected with this. So, Genesis 6 just multiplies what happened with Lilith. What happened with Eve temporarily, but Eve is a type of repentance, the bride of Christ. So,
and also,
what should we be doing? What should we be doing? We should be watchers. What a prophecy, watchers for God, not watchers for the devil. Watchers for God, you can interpret world events. You can interpret those superheroes. You can interpret those people going to malls, swimming and excursions, singing worldly music, worldly movies. You can interpret the message for the children of God. The children of God has a message that from what's happening in the world. And only the watchers, the ministers of God, the fivefold ministry in the end time, can interpret them for, as a message for protection to the children of God. Okay, so you did not open. Could you open finally the verse, watch and pray? Barmenan, look for that verse. Okay, Brother Simon.
I have a question.
Final question.
Okay, here on my illustration, I'm going to
watch and pray. Look for that, Brother Menan, or anyone else. Watch and pray.
Here.
Matthew 24.
Oh, yeah. On this illustration.
Could you speak louder, Brother Simon? Your voice sound sleepy.
Can you see my screen, Gus?
Okay, what's your short question?
So you can see that there is a supernatural, like this guy. He has that vision or dreams like this girl. He has that power like bow, circle around there, or what is that like yet Spider-Man. So as you can see on this illustration, these superheroes had the demon spirit or like evil spirit. So can it be exist, or can it really exist on us? Like we have that fornication spirit, incubus, succubus, supernatural.
Can we have supernatural power? That's your question, yes. Right?
Yes. Can we have, like, it can really exist on ours? Like, you know, we have...
Okay. Shortcut your question. I got your question already. Okay? So, we can, that the demonic side. As true believers, we have power from God. But the difference is, we do not recklessly use our power for our own ends, for display, or whatever.
Okay. So, okay, I can clearly understand that. So, if we can, we can also throw a spider web like Spider-Man like that.
I already answered you. Let me repeat. We will not be the same as them, except you want to backslide, okay? You want to turn to the dark side. Anakin Skywalker, okay? If you want to turn to the dark side, the devil will give you more power. If you watch the movie Star Wars, it's a parallel of the Jedi are forbidden certain powers. And the Sith tempting Anakin Skywalker, they're withholding to you this power. The serpent is telling Eve, you will become like gods. Why are you forbidden to touch that? Okay?
So I do really believe that we can have that supernatural power because there's a witchcraft or a supernatural powers like now, like throwing things like this and healing the, like, you know, Kulam.
Telekinesis, teleportation. Yes.
Kulam.
Telepathy.
Yes, do you know that?
Vexing, hexing, that's hexing.
Yes, hexing.
Placing a curse. Okay. Okay, so so much for that. I'm gonna read the verse. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. So who's gonna watch? The believer. It's not the angels already watching you, watching over you. Angels watching over me by Immigrant. So we're gonna play Watch and Pray by Twilight Paris, okay? Because the enemy is there, not just against us, not just against our family, against our church brethren. If you love our church brethren, you will help watch and pray for them also. So these are the human watchers. We have to be watchers also in order for us to be caught up like Enoch. Okay, so much for that.
So already time, Brother Francis?
Yes. Please give us a closing prayer.
Okay, thank you for this day, Lord. And thank you for the wonderful topic. And I hope those who will watch this video and hear this broadcast will enlighten and ask question for this topic. And thank you for those who help out for this broadcast possible done. But thank you for our brethren here in the room. Brother Joshua, Brother Simon, Sister Juana, Brother David, and others, and Il. And anoint us, Lord, and forgive us in our sin. And bless Brother Francis for the wonderful revelation that you've given us, Lord. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.